welcome to the Garda Choir from Cork. This is the last Sunday before Lent, so just making a real celebration of the Lord's Day. In our Gospel this morning, Jesus tells us that the Father loves all his children, those who deserve his love and those who do not, and urges us to invites us to embrace in an all-inclusive love everyone, even those we don't like, even those who may be our enemies. So let us pause a moment and reflect as we begin our Eucharist and ask the Lord to give us the grace to love each other. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have
of his offense. This way, you will not take sin upon yourself.
Jesus said to his disciples, "You have learned how it was said, eye for eye and tooth for tooth. But I say this to you, offer no resistance to the wicked. On the contrary, if anyone hits you on the right cheek, offer the other as well. If anyone takes you to law and will have your tunic, give your cloak as well. And if anyone orders you to go 1 mile, go the second also. Give to anyone who asks, and if anyone wants to borrow, do not turn away. You have learned how it is said, you must love your neighbor and hate your enemy. But I say this to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. In this way you will be children of your Father in heaven, for he causes his sun to rise on the bad as well as on the good, and his rain to fall on the upright and the wicked alike. For if you love those who love you, what right have you to claim any credit? Even the tax collector do as much, do they not? And if you say your greetings for your brothers and sisters, are you doing anything exceptional? Even the pagans do as much, do they not? You must therefore be perfect, for Heavenly Father is perfect." The Gospel of the Lord. As we listen to this Gospel, we might be inclined to dismiss it lightly as not really applying to us. I say it's probably almost certain that none of us here could say that we actually hate anybody. And yet today, there are hate laws written into our criminal code. Throughout Europe, as well as America, Canada, Australia, and New Zealand, there are hate laws. A poster put out by the Garda Síochána shows a placard being held by hands of many colours, from black to brown to white. And the placard says, "Let's stop hate altogether." It urges us, the public, to report hate crime to the Gardaí. The poster gives us a definition of a hate crime as a criminal offence. We may not know about this, but an offence motivated by hostility or prejudice based on actual or perceived age, disability, race, colour, nationality, ethnicity, religion, sexual orientation, and hatred is love and forgiveness, or forgiving love. Another thing we can remember is that we're all somehow related. We're all connected to each other. We have no nice and cozy, but it's not what Jesus is saying.
bring our prayers now to our Father God, God of compassion and mercy, and God who is slow to anger and rich in mercy.
The Gospel of St. Matthew today reminds us to love our enemies and pray for those who hurt or offend or persecute us. We pray for grace to forgive them and respond to God's call to love Him and love our neighbour. We pray to the Lord. On this February Sunday, as spring struggles forth with storm, wind and rain, we pray for an end to the harshness of wars, violence, aggression and murder in our own country and throughout the world. We pray to the Lord. Today is Temperance Sunday. Let us pray for all who struggle with addictions, such as misuse of drugs, alcohol, gambling. We pray that victims will find courage and support to overcome their distress and their loss of their addictions. We pray to the Lord. We pray for all the young people of our country that they will choose a positive path in their lives so that their full potential and contribution to society can be fully realized. Lord, hear our prayer. As Ash Wednesday approaches, let us remind ourselves of our duty and care of God's creation, planet Earth. We pray for our incoming government that they will work harmoniously for the good of all people on this island, all our own well-being and our ecology. We pray to the Lord. We ask the love, mercy and compassion of Jesus to each marginalized person, the distressed, the anxious, the ill and infirm, the immigrant, those without adequate shelter and members of ethnic minorities. We pray to the Lord. We pray for this community of sisters who dwell within this beautiful place of spirituality and prayer, Glencairn Abbey. We ask God to bless their work, their building project, and their continuous consideration of all who request their prayers and compassion. We pray to the Lord.
Gracious Father, for your mercy and forgiveness, we thank you for hearing our prayers, and we will make them through our Lord Jesus.
There is hatred, let me bring your
we celebrate the mysteries, O Lord, with the observance that is your due, we humbly ask you that what we offer to the honor of your majesty may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For out of compassion for the waywardness that is ours, he humbled himself under the form of the Virgin. By the passion of the cross, he freed us from unending death, and by rising from the dead, he gave us life eternal. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim. Filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your good of church and earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and the apostles, our bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people who have been for your word. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, who have been summoned before you. Be your compassion and mercy to Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world, to our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you that are passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom, that we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Grant this through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, and Son, and Holy Spirit. The Mass is ended.